السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. We read today from Surah Ar-Rum. And Surah Ar-Rum starts with the cut off letters, with the حروف المقطعة. ألف لام ميم. And it is one of three surahs that in which after the حروف المقطعه there is no mention of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran. Alif lam mim ghulibat ar-rum. This is Surah Ar-Rum. Alif lam mim hasiba an-nas an yutraku an yaqulu amanna wa hum la yuftanun. Surah Al-Ankabut. And Surah Maryam kaf ayah al-insan dhikru rahmati rabbika 'abdahu Zakariya. So these three surahs, after the حروف مقطعه there is no mention of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or an indication to that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts the surah with غُلِبَتْ الروم, that the Romans have been defeated. غُلِبَتْ الروم. And the Romans comprises a lot of people. Those are from the Italians, for example. The Latins are also Rome. The Polish, the Czechs, the Russians. Yeah, it comprises a lot of nations, and they are mixed nations. They are mixed together. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that the Romans have been defeated في أدنى الأرض. غلبت الروم في أدنى الأرض. There was a battle between the Persians and the Romans. And that, scholars say, happened in Syria, or some say between Jordan and Palestine. But it happened in the Sham, in the area of the Sham land. So in that battle, the place is nearest to the Arab land. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, fi adn al-ard, in the nearer land. So it's the nearest to the Arab land. And some scholars said this spot is actually the lowest on earth. This is the lowest spot on earth. في أدنى الأرض. The lowest spot where this battle took place is the lowest part in the world. And the satellites found out that actually this spot is the lowest on earth, and it is 392 meters below sea level. 392 meters below sea level, the lowest on earth. What about the Romans who fell in an hour? And the Romans have been defeated by the Persians, as we said, and the Persians were able to conquer Constantinople, Constantinia. They were able to conquer that. And the Romans were defeated badly. So no one at that time would expect that the Romans will turn to defeat the Persians. There was no chance for them to do that, given what is given at that time, because they were defeated so badly. هزم الروم يعني هزيمة النكراء بحيث لم يعتقد أحد أنهم سينهضون من جديد ويتغلبون على على الفرس. But Allah سبحانه and because of this occasion, because of this battle, the polytheists of Quraysh were rejoicing, because they considered the Persians as their partners, because they both are mushriks, both are polytheists. The Majus, you know, the Persians, were worshipping the fire and worshipping the sun and the moon, and the mushriks of Quraysh were worshipping the idols. So they were both polytheists, and they rejoiced at the victory of the Persians over the Romans. And they said to the Muslims that as the Persians defeated the Romans, we will also defeat you. So the Muslims, of course, were saddened at that, because they considered the Romans, which were Christians, closer to them than the polytheists. So they went to Rasulullah and informed him of what the mushriks of Quraysh were saying. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed those ayahs. وَلِبَتُ الْرُومُ فِي أَدْنَ الْأَرْضِ وَهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ غَلَبِهِمْ ومن بعد غلبهم two ways of it. ومن بعد غلبهم سيغلبون في بضع سنين. And after the Romans were defeated, they will end up being victorious in a few years. بضع سنين. And بضع سنين, scholars say it is between 3 to 10 years or 3 to 9 years. And Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, the revered companion of Rasulullah, when he heard those ayahs, he went to the mushriks and told them, you shouldn't be rejoicing now, because the Romans will end up being victorious. They will defeat the Persians again. And Ubay ibn Khalaf said, do you bet? And Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu said, yes, I bet. Because there was no prohibition about this, because this is sort of gambling before. But it was no prohibition, sent down to prohibit this kind of rehan, this kind of gambling. So they bet on 10 camels. Like if the Romans will end up victorious, then Ubay ibn Khalaf will give 10 camels to Sayyidina Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And if it's the opposite, Sayyidina Abu Bakr will give 10 camels to him. And Sayyidina Abu Bakr, because he thought, the bid'ah sinin is between 3 and 9, he gave a respite for 3 years only. But when he came back to Rasulullah, Rasulullah told him that bid'ah sinin means between 3 and 9 or 3 to 10. So you shouldn't have said 3 years, because this is the least of the bid'ah sinin, the least of the, you should have some, set forth something in between. So Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu returned to Ubay ibn Khalaf, and Rasulullah told Abu Bakr to increase the amount, the number of candles, and to extend the period. So Sayyidina Abu Bakr suggested to Ubay to increase it to 100 candles and to extend the period to 9 years. Between 3 and 9. And when Ubay ibn Khalaf participated in the battle of Badr, and he was injured by Rasulullah, injured him. And he, as a consequence of that injury, died. Then Abdurrahman, the son of Abi Bakr, Allah be pleased with them. Before he died, he told him, what about the bet? So if you die, then what's going to happen? And he said, my son will give you the bet. And the same thing when Sayyidina Abu Bakr went outside, Ubay told him, who is going to guarantee the bet? And Sayyidina Abu Bakr said, Abdurrahman will guarantee it. So if either one dies, then their sons will give those bets. And it happened that on the day of Badr, the mouth of Badr, battle of Badr, when the Muslims ended up being victorious over the mushriks, the same thing happened. The Romans defeated the Persians on the same day. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, غلبت الروم في هذا الأرض ومن بعد غيرهم سيغلبون في السنين لله الأمر من قبل ومن بعد. The matter belongs to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Who defeats whom is a matter of Allah's decision, not anybody else. لله الأمر من قبل ومن بعد. Before the defeat of the Romans and after the victory of the Romans. This is all belongs to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ويومئذ يفرح المؤمنون. And on that day, the day of Badr, the believers will rejoice at the victory of the Romans over the Persians. They rejoice at the victory of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَنْصُرُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الرَّحِيمُ. He makes whomever he wills victorious. And he makes whomever he wills defeated. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. He is the Almighty, the all wise. And this is, subhanAllah, as I said, no one expected the Romans to defeat the Persians. And this is a mu'jiza for Rasulullah, a miracle that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, saying that the Romans will defeat the Persians after a few years, which exactly happened. The seventh year, on the seventh year, the Romans were able to defeat the Persians again. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَعْدَ اللَّهِ. This is the promise of Allah. لَا يُخْلِفُ اللَّهُ وَعْدَهُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never fails to his promise. وَعْدَ اللَّهِ لَا يُخْلِفُ اللَّهُ وَعْدَهُ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. But most of the people, they don't know that the promise of Allah will take place, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never fails to implement his promise. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. They don't know. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ عَنِ الْآخِرَةِ هُمْ غَافِلُونَ. They only know what appears in the life of this world, but they are about the hereafter oblivious. They are oblivious to the hereafter. They are heedless of the hereafter. They don't know nothing about the hereafter, nor are they concerned about it. They are only immersed in this dunya. They only know, even in this dunya, they only know what some of its appearances, not all. Because remember, they discover something, and then after a while, they find that they were wrong. So they modify, and they keep on modifying things. Because they only know what's apparent, and they don't have the whole picture. And especially, they are ignorant about the hereafter. يَعْلَمُونَ ظَاهِرًا مِنَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ عَنِ الْآخِرَةِ هُمْ غَافِلُونَ. هُمْ, another article that specifies them. هُمْ عَنِ الْآخِرَةِ هُمْ غَافِلُونَ. They are the ones who are heedless. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then draws their attention to reflect. أَوَلَمْ يَتَفَكَّرُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ. Haven't they, pondered and reflected within themselves? مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ وَأَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not created heavens and earth except by the truth and to an appointed time. It will be, يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. This world, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created it in a perfect condition. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He wills, He can destroy this as well. And He can recreate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, كَمَا بَدَأْنَا أَوَّلَ خَلْقٍ نُعِيدُهُ وَعْدًا عَلَيْنَا إِنَّا كُنَّا فَاعِلِينَ. As we have started the creation, we can repeat it. We can create it after it is destroyed. So it draws, He draws attention of those qualities to ponder and reflect. That there will be a day of reckoning. There will be a day of resurrection. They will be held accountable on that day before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a proof of that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look at the creation of the heavens and the earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created them for a purpose. أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَشًا. Do you think that we only created you for nothing, in vain? So think and ponder and know the purpose of your creation. مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ وَأَجَلٍ مُسَمًّى. What's next? مَا خَلَقَ اللَّهُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ وَأَجَلٍ مُسَمًّى. وَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّهِمْ لَكَافِرُونَ. And many of the people, they actually disbelieve in the meeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are disbelievers, many of them. وَإِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ بِلِقَاءِ رَبِّهِمْ لَكَافِرُونَ. But many of them as well, they believe in Allah in the hereafter. Because at that time as well, there were the Christians, there were the Jews. So they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the unity of Allah. At least one sect of the Christianity, because they also turned to be polytheists after that. And they worshipped Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam and his mother and and the Trinity and so forth. وإن كثيرا من الناس بيدفع ربهم كافرون أولم يسيروا في الأرض فينظروا كيف كان عاقبة الذين من قبلهم كانوا أشد منهم قوة وأثاروا الأرض وعمروها أكثر مما عمروها وجاءتهم رسلهم بالبينات فما كان الله ليظلمهم ولكن كانوا أنفسهم يظلمون. They said, don't they ponder and reflect? Don't they know that when they have their trip to Asham and their trip to Yemen, when they go to the Sham, they pass by the villages of Lut and the villages of Thamud, and they see the ruins of those people because of the torment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't they see that when they have their trip to the Sham? And don't they see the ruins of Ad when they go to Yemen? So they have two trips, one in winter and one in summer. One goes to the Sham and one goes to the Yemen, the caravans, of trade caravans. So on their way to Sham or Yemen, they see the ruins of those people who denied Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, denied the signs of Allah, and disbelieved in Allah, and were stubborn. So don't they see the ruins of those people and hear the lesson from that, that might happen to them as well? And they were even stronger than Quraysh, the polytheists of Quraysh, Ad and Thamud. They were even stronger than the Qurayshite, the polytheists of Quraysh. And they have tilled the earth and harvested the earth and built, you know, great buildings and so forth. And they were more populous than polytheists of Quraysh. In comparison to them, the polytheists of Quraysh are nothing. وَكَانُوا أَشَدَّ مِنْ قُوَّةٍ وَأَثَارُوا الْأَرْضَ وَعَمَرُوهَا أَكْثَرَ مِمَّا عَمَرُوهَا وَجَاءَتْهُمْ رُسُلُهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. And their messengers came to them with the clear signs. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say فَكَذَّبُوا. He said right away, فَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't have wronged them, but they themselves were wronged their own selves. So it is understood that they denied the messengers and they disbelieved in the message of the messengers to them. فَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيَظْلِمَهُمْ وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أنفسهم مظلمون. ثم كان عاقبة الذين أساءوا السوء أن كذبوا بآيات الله وكانوا بها يستهزئون. ثم كان عاقبة with the فتحة أو ثم كان عاقبة الذين two ways of reading the ayah. And عاقبة is the end and then the end of those people was the worst end. ثم كان عاقبة الذين أساءوا السوء. As-su'a is the feminine word for al-aswad. Like al-husna, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. Al-husna is the feminine word of al-ahsan. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. وَهَذُوَ عَقِبَةُ السُّوءَ الَّذِينَ سَاءُ السُّوءَ. Su'a is the female or the feminine article for al-aswad, the worst. ثم كان عاقبة الذين أساءوا السوء أن كذبوا بآيات الله. Because they belied the signs of Allah. أن كذبوا بآيات الله وكانوا بها يستهزئون. They were mocking, you know, the signs of Allah as well. They were ridiculing and looking down upon the signs of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. ثم كان عاقبة الذين أساءوا السوء أن كذبوا بآيات الله وكانوا بها يستهزئون. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then draws the attention to His ability and greatness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahu yabda'u al-khalqa thumma yu'idu. He starts the creation and then He repeats it after it is destructed, after it is destroyed. Allahu yabda'u al-khalqa thumma yu'idu thumma ilayhi turja'un. And then you all are going to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa yawma al-qiyamati wa yawma taqum al-sa'an. You know, on the day when the hour is established, يُبْلِسُ الْمُجْرِمُونَ. They will be dumbstruck and that day, on that day the mushriks will be dumbstruck and they will be despairing. They will have no hope of salvation, of being rescued from the torment of Allah. ويوم تقوم الساعة يبلس المجرمون ولم يكن لهم من شركائهم شفعاء وكانوا بشركائهم كافرين. And no one of their gods that they used to worship in this dunya will come to support them. You know, they say these are our intercessors, that they were intercede on our behalf before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But no one of their so-called intercessors will come to their rescue on that day. وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةِ وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَفَرَّقُونَ. And when the hours go to be established, they will split. They will split in two groups. Now, and Surah Al-Baqarah talks about three groups, but this one group includes both Al-Muqarrabun and Ashab al-Yameen. There are those who are near to Allah and the people of the right. وَيَوْمَ تَقُومُ السَّاعَةُ يَوْمَئِذٍ يَتَفَرَّقُونَ. فأما الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فهم في روضة يحبرون. Those who have believed and did righteous deeds, they are going to be in gardens rejoicing. They will be joyful. You know, until that joy and happiness will appear on their faces. من الحبر. You know, السرور الذي يظهر على الوجوه. يومئذٍ فهم في روضة يحبرون. وأما الذين كفروا, but those who disbelieve, وكذبوا بآياتنا, and denied our science, ولقاء الآخرة, and the meeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter, فأولئك في العذاب محضرون. They will be brought to be tormented. They will be brought to punishment, to the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فسبحان الله. Glorified be Allah. Subhanallah. حِينَ تُمْسُونَ in the coming of the evening. وَحِينَ تُصْبِحُونَ in the coming of the morning. وَلَهُ الْحَمْدُ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. And all praise belongs to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala in the heavens and in the earth. وَعَشِيًّا and in the afternoon. وَحِينَ تُظْهِرُونَ and in at noon as well. And ulama said that these are the times of prayer. Subhanallah. من الصبح الصبح الصلاة, you know, prayer specifically talks about the prayer, but also علماء said this also talks about ذكر الله, the remembrance of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى says سبحان الله حين تمسون المساء, اللي هو قدوم المغرب, you know, the coming of the sunset. So there is صلاة المغرب and then صلاة العشاء حين تمسون, وحين تصبحون صلاة الفجر, you know, the morning, the coming of the morning is Salat al-Fajr. Ashiya is in the evening, which is Salat al-Asr. Wahina tudhirun Salat al-Dhuhr. So the five prayers are implied in this ayah. Subhanallah, Hina tumsuna, Wahina tusbihun, Wala alhamdu al-Samawati wal-Ardi wa Ashiya, Wahina tudhirun. Yukhriju al-Hayya min al-Mayyit. He brings out the living from the dead and brings out the dead from the living. يخرج الحي من الميت ويخرج الميت من الحي, bringing the dead from the living. You know, it is seen and bringing the dead from the living. It is also, there are examples of that. You know, for example, the egg. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates from it, you know, the little creature, the eggs, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is dead, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings out something that is living from it. يُخْرِ الْحَيَّ مِنْ الْمَيْتِ وَيُخْرِ الْمَيْتِ مِنْ الْحَيِّ وَيُحْيِ الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. He revives the earth after it was dead. وَيُحْيِ الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا وَكَذَلِكَ تُخْرَجُونَ. And so you will also be brought out from the earth after you were dead, from the graves. Similarly, this is the way also you would be brought forth or brought out of your graves. وَكَذَلِكَ تُخْرَجُونَ. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ. You will continue or you want to go? وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ أَنْ خَلَقَ لَكُمْ مِنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. أَنْ خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ ثُمَّ إِذَا أَنْتُمْ بَشَرٌ تَنْتَشِرُونَ. and of his science, of his great science. So these ayat, the verses, they are all talk about the greatness of Allah and the great ability of his subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِمْ خَلَقُكُمْ مِنْ تُرَابٍ. Now out of his science is that he created you from dust, and then you are human beings spreading all over the earth. ثُمَّ إِذَا أَنْتُمْ بَشَرٌ تَنْتَشِرُونَ. وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِمْ خَلَقَكُمْ مِنْ أَنْفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. Another his science is that he created for you spouses so that you find tranquility therein. And he made between you mawaddah and rahmah, compassion and love and mercy. Indeed, therein there are signs for people who reflect, and people who understand and who ponder and reflect upon the verses and the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خلق السماوات والأرض. His science is the creation of the heavens and the earth. واختلاف ألسنتكم وألوانكم. And the variety and the differences in color and in tongues. You have so many languages. I don't know how many languages in the world. 250 languages in the world or more. You know, these are signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are the same human being, the same thing, but we have different languages. And we have different colors. Some of us are black, some of us are white, some of us are red, some of us are yellow. يعني سبحان الله. And these are signs of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وإن آياته خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف ألسنتكم وألوانكم. إن في ذلك لآيات للعالمين. And therein there is actually signs for those people of knowledge. There are two ways of reading للعالمين. للعالمين للعالمين. And with the fatha or with the kasra. Al-alamin means for people of knowledge. Al-alamin. Al-alamin